podcast is sponsored by Easy Excel. Don't Fear the Spreadsheet podcast, episode number 14, read only. Hey, welcome back to the Don't Fear the Spreadsheet podcast. I'm Bill Jelen. Today's question, Tyler Nash.
Mr. Excel, you're going to be pretty proud of me. I made this perfect workbook, but I have to share it with my coworkers, and I do not want them making any changes to it at all. Is there any way that I can make the workbook just like read only?
All right, Tyler. Hey, yeah, there's a couple of ways to go. Microsoft Excel 2010 gives us a brand new way, but I'm not sure that I like it. So I'm going to compare and contrast the two of these. The book actually shows the old way, and that's the way that seems to work a lot better. So we have your document here, and by the way, hey, nice job. This is from the first case study in the book. Lots of cool formatting there. Nice job. So file, save as, and I'm not going to save it as read only first. I'm just going to save it as a regular old file. So let's just call it 000 first way. All right, so that's method number one. And then I'm going to save it. I'm going to show you method number two. File save as. We'll go 000 second way. I'm going to have to find these in Windows Explorer later. That's why I'm using the 000 to get them to the top of the list. An old trick there. All right, so the new method is we go to File, and Info is selected here under Protect Workbook. They have something called Mark as Final. Let the readers know that the workbook is final and make it read only. Well, I mean, that sounds like exactly like what we need. It's going to be marked as final and then saved. And we click OK, and it says that editing is complete. This is the final version of the document. Oh, yeah, that sounds great. Click OK. All right, so now here we are. Let's close both of these. All right, so method two, we used mark as final. Method one, you can't actually do in Excel. You have to come out to Windows Explorer and find the file that you just saved. So here it is. I'm going to right click that file and come down here and choose properties. Now in properties, I'm going to mark it as read only. Click OK. All right, now we're going to compare back in Excel how the two of these work. First of all, we'll do the second wave file. So we'll open the second wave file. And sure enough, it says, hey, it's marked as final. They marked this final, marked this workbook as final to discourage editing. I didn't mark it as final to discourage editing. I marked it as final to prevent editing. And look how easy it is to break this. They give them a big, huge button that says, edit anyway. Bam, it's no longer read-only. That seems really, really pointless. I mean, if we're trying to protect the file from our coworkers, this isn't protecting it because it just gives them a big, huge edit anyway. You want to make it a little bit tougher than that. All right, so I'm not a big fan of that. I'm sure that started out to be much tougher than it was, and someone must have talked the Excel team down before the product came out. But let's go back to the first way. This is the one where we set the read-only flag in Windows Explorer. All right, so this opens up as read-only. If I would make some changes and even, you know, screw something up, like put Saturday here, and then when I go to save, it says no deal, it's read-only. Okay, so I'm going to use save as, and I'm going to try and write it right back over the file. All right, so I'm still trying to save my changes. Click save, and it says no. Do you want to replace it? Yes. No, it's set to read only. You have to try again with a different name. So this one, using the read only flag in Windows Explorer, seems to be the much better way to actually protect that workbook. Well, hey, check out the book, Don't Fear the Spreadsheet, 150 beginner Q&A. It'll get you from level 1 all the way up to level 3, maybe even a little bit of level 4. This book makes Excel for Dummies look like it was written for rocket scientists.